I'm here with Jeroen Navis, IT, privacy and innovation lawyer at State Advocate Pels, Rijken, Droogleveren en Fortuin. Jeroen, your office created the first legal blockchain certificate. What does that mean?
People come to us and they ask us, okay, where can we buy this certificate? That's of course not really how it works. It's more than that, it's really an advice. We advise companies, startups, governments who created their own blockchain, and we advise them on all the legal aspects that are possibly involved in this blockchain. And what we do is that we translate this legal requirements into technical solutions together with the developers who are building this blockchain. So, and in the end, that leads to a list of advices to the builder of the blockchain. And in the end, if everything works out, we give them the certificate. So it's not something you can just buy and say, okay, I want this certificate, here you go. No, it's of course an advising process, and in the end, everything is compliant with applicable law and regulation.
Was there one most challenging aspect when you worked on this blockchain certificate?
Yeah, of course, every blockchain is different. In most blockchains, there are a few common legal questions like identification, smart contracts. But of course, every blockchain is different. If you're going to apply a blockchain in the healthcare sector, you need to apply to healthcare law. If you are going to apply a blockchain in the energy sector, you have to deal with energy law. The most complicated thing, if there is personal data inside the blockchain, you have to deal with data protection law. That's of course really difficult, because data protection law has, for example, the idea that you, the right to be forgotten. You have to be able to erase information. Well, the idea of the blockchain is, of course, that you're not able to erase information. So, that's a difficult thing and a challenging thing.
You described the legal blockchain certificate as kind of a process, actually.
Yeah.
Is it a final version of the process? Do you think it will improve in the future?
I think the process is now already really good. And of course, what I said, it really depends on the blockchain. So it's not one standard process, or of course the steps are the same, but the legal requirements depends on the blockchain. So I think it will develop, but every blockchain is different. So it's not something we can say, okay, we do that, here you go. No, it depends.
All right. You spoke about translating legal requirements into technical solutions.
Yeah.
Now, blockchain technology has lots of regulatory aspects in the technology. So is it possible that maybe one day the technology also affects legal requirements?
Of course, it's a difficult question. It's a little bit looking into the future, but our starting point is, okay, we're going to make this innovation possible within the borders of the current legislation. We're not going to change the law, because that will take years, and our clients want to innovate right now. What you see in, especially when you look to regulations, what you see there are mostly focused on, there are a few laws who really focus on a central database, and of course that's going to be a problem. I don't think the reason behind the rules going to change, but in some cases, when you look to cryptocurrency, financial laws focused on the bank, and now we have a financial system without a bank. So I think the idea behind the rule won't change, but maybe some legislation will change.